Good morning, boys and girls, and if you're watching this video, you're going to love what I'm going to do today. Okay. So, today, we are going to make this. A Christmas tree. We're going to make what? A Christmas tree. And all these gifts and drums, if you see the bottom, has drums in the top. They're all from Dollar Tree. So, what you need is an empty cereal box. You need some tape. You need a pair of scissors. And you need these amazing packages that you can get at Dollar Tree. Okay? And I have a few here open. So I'm going to teach you how to make it using some circles that you see and a marker, a permanent marker. All right? So the first thing you need to have is an empty cereal box. Empty means nothing inside. Okay? So this is something that you can recycle. You know what recycle means, right? It means we're going to use it for something else, right? Well, why not make a Christmas tree? So what I'm doing is I'm cutting the tops of my cereal box because that's the first thing I have to do. So if you're at home, you can actually do this with your mom, with your dad, with a brother or sister because you're going to need some help on cutting this box. All right? So once the adult cuts the box, right, you're going to open the bottom, right, and continue cutting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut one side right, right on the side of the box because I want it open, okay? Now I'm going to cut the other side of what it's holding. And this is what I need. For now, this is what I need. So I'm going to take this top off. And if you have noticed, this is a fine motor activity that you can do to develop a very good way of making crafts, of, you know, cutting better. Because this is not paper. This is recycled paper. This is cardboard. And you can also be a person who likes to do crafts, which means you like to do things and make them, probably sell them. All right? And so that makes this reusable as well. So don't throw some of these because you're going to need them later. Okay? So I'm going to put these to the side because what I'm going to do is I'm going to bend over my camera so that you can see what I want you to see. Okay, so now we have this cardboard, and I'm going to take a bowl, you know, a cereal bowl, right? This bowl, what you're going to use is the circle shape. The circle is not on the bottom, it's actually on the top. So you're going to put it facing down. Okay, you're going to place it somewhere in the cardboard to make sure that you can make a circle of the cardboard. You hold with one hand the bowl and the other hand makes the circle around. And voila, you just made a circle. Now, that's not the only one I need. So I'm going to need, you know, those cereal bowls that they sell at the supermarket? Well, take an empty one, put it facing down, and continue, whoops, tracing around. My marker looks like it wants to play. All right, so now I made a smaller circle. The next circle can come from a cup. You know, one of those paper cups? You can actually take one and facing down, that's your size. So, I'm going to make another circle right here. Now, I'm going to be very wise. I'm going to use the bottom of the circle as well. Now, how do I do that? Well, put it facing up, hold it with one hand, and you make another circle. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 circles. It's time to cut. And that's the most important part of this event. Because if you don't cut the circles of the cardboard, you see, it was a cereal box, then you're not going to be able to make the Christmas tree. So if you can, cut the small ones and let the adult cut the big ones. Because this kind of cutting can actually hurt a little bit your hand if you're not a person who knows how to cut. If you're a person who likes to cut or knows how to cut, you will do it moving the circle. Not the scissor, the circle. The circle moves and the scissor cuts the circle on the cardboard. So now we have our third circle, and that gives you an opportunity to know you're almost done. The rest of the scraps that you have, you can recycle them. They'll take any scraps of cardboard, trust me. And here I am on my last circle, which happens to be smaller, right? And that is going to give me an opportunity to do this. Put it on the side. All right, so now we are going to start taping some of those presents and drums. In this case, the big one is the one that we start with, right? So I'm going to put these to the side. Just remember they're there. And we're going to start taping drums. Drums or gifts that are big should start first. But I don't have enough of the gifts because my kids have been using it a lot. So I'm going to use the ones that are left over, which are the drums. We have silver and we have gold. They come in red and also in blue. They come in 4 different colors. Now, these drums are very important to us because when they come with this little attachment. And you don't need that if you're doing a Christmas tree, okay? So now we have 3 that we can start, and now I can take out my scotch tape and start rolling it. So you're going to make the opposite wet sticks, stick one behind the other like this, okay? You're gonna stick it on the bottom. You see where it sticks on the bottom? And then you're going to place it on the edge of the circle. The edge of the circle. So I'm going to do it again. I'm going to tape it but roll it backwards. Right? I'm going to take it and stick it on the drum. And I'm going to place the drum right next to the other one on the edge of the circle. And the reason why I'm doing it is because we are trying to make the Christmas tree. So now I'm going to take out the red one and the blue one. So you see I just did this. It's because I want it to be colorful. I wanted you to know that this is something easy that you can do for the holiday. And actually get a good grip of what it is. And you can actually make presents for your family. So again, we roll it backwards. We stick on one side the tape. And then we stick it on the edge of (clears throat) of the circle. And I'm going to do the same thing with the red. And so now I have silver, gold, blue, and red drums. Now I have to continue. So I'm going to continue with what I have. So I'm going to try to pull out a silver because that's what I need. And another red and... And so this is the part that probably you will have some time to prepare first so it can get done. You will see the second part of this video later or the next day, but you can start by making the first part, right? So I'm going to take the silver one, stick the tape, stick it on the edge, right? I'm going to take the gold one, take the tape, stick it on the drum, stick it on the edge, okay? You see, I'm adding it as I go. Again. Yep. Somebody got me sick last week. And here is the next one. Now I'm down to probably one drum. I don't want to put silver, but I'm going to put gold. Okay? Because originally that's what I was going to do. I was going to put gold there, but I didn't. So there he goes. And you do like this. And you always do this. Now, you can have an opening. It doesn't matter because you're going to hide that as you go. So this is the first level. Now we get to do the second level by putting a smaller circle of cardboard on here. And what you do is you tape the cardboard onto the drums or the gifts, if you have presents or gifts that you just stuck. So when you do it, you have to make sure that you are not moving the circle because it has to stay still, okay? It cannot be moved. Now, we're going to use presents. And so this is where it gets very, indeed, very, very interesting. So we're going to take, again, the same colors, red, blue, silver, and gold. And you're going to tape it under the gift. And you start on the edge of that. Okay? And it goes like this. All right? So this is how you roll it. This is what you do to the present. Okay, and you stick it, and then you stick it on the edge. So I'm going to continue with these gifts. I have a silver one here. Okay. And we will continue on the second video of this. So this would be the first video. It's very important that you follow the videos and that you subscribe and press like. And if you do say subscribe, you will have access to all of my videos that I have done on YouTube. And that will be awesome because then you will have access to many, many videos that I've done since last year. Last school year, I should say, because it's still this year, 2020. All right, I'm going to take a red one because I think it will fit perfect. And I'm going to do this. And so there goes the second part of our Christmas tree. And remember, smart is not something you are. Smart is something you get.